Hello guys, how are you? I hope you're all safe. And today's tutorial is I will be showing to you what is the use and what is the function of each button, as you can see on our main monitor of this CNC mill. This machine guys is CNC horizontal mill NHP8000 from machine tool. Let's begin guys. Tell you more about all the function and uses of each button. This is quite different from other CNC mill. Many of them are you cannot find on any CNC milling machine. So guys, this is the time for you to know more about this machine. So let's do it together and let's begin. This is edit, where you can edit your programs if you want to change, if you want to insert. Also on edit you can make new program, so or you can copy those things that you can do on edit. The second button is our auto or the memory. So if you are going to run your program in full sequence, then you are going to select your memory. And this third button is the RMT. So if you are going to run your machine and plug in into your computer, then connected to your data interface LAN port, so you are going to connect your computer on this port. Button guys is your MDI. So MDI is manual data input, where you can command your machine, like you want to make a tool change, you want to position on your datum. And in MDI guys, after you command, it will be gone. Unlike if you are in auto mode or memory, if you cycle start your program, it is still on the machine. But in MDI, once you cycle start, your program is gone, or once you reset, it will be gone. So this is the button if you want to reference all your access, Z, Y, X and B axis. So guys, this is your spindle. It is BT40 tapered. And guys, up and down is your Y axis. And going to horizontal is your X axis. And forward and backward is your Z axis. And then this is your V axis, which is the table of the machine. And then the next button guys is your jog and the rapid. If you want to move your machine quickly, you can do it manually using the rapid and just press the button X, then you're going to move your X. And then guys, that one is Y positive, this one is Y negative, and then this one guys is your Z, and that's your Z axis, your table. And then guys, this one is your handle. So if you are on handle, you need to use your hand wheel to move your machine or your table. So you must use this hand wheel. You want to stop your spindle, press this one. And if your spindle is running, this button is also have lights like this. And you have your percentage of your rapid or jog. So you have 0%, 25%, 50%, and 100%. And this machine guys, the NHP8000, is the rapid of this machine is very quick, unlike other machines, especially the 100%.
And since this machine is there is no 5 axis, so this one is not working. And you have guys single black, this button is your black skip, you have your MO1 or optional stop, you have your dry run, this button guys is your machine lock status, so machine internal lock. This one guys is, you can see there is N, and this one is for neutral. If you are running your machine in auto pallet chains, this one must be on. Then guys, this one is your also machine lock status, all axis is lock, and this one is only for Z is lock. The next button guys is going to your tool change point, but if you want to use this button, you must be in rapid or jog. And this one guys is your, if you want to reference your table without commanding in MDI, also you must be in rapid. So that is the button. You can see the table is referencing to its reference position. So once that one is referenced, your axis is, there's a light. This button guys is your machine position to going to X200 and Y350. This button guys is for your tool management. So if you want to see your tool management, you must press this button, or in other way you can use the custom number 1, close this one, and then you can go to tool data, they are all the same. And then the next button guys is for your tool monitor for the loads of your machine. So if you want to see that one, you can press this. And this button guys is for your, it will home position your machine on X, Y, and Z. So this one, as you can see, there is a reference symbol if you are doing rigid tapping and you stop your tapping cycle without canceling it. And then if you do that one, you cannot move your machine unless you press this one, and you must be in rapid or jog. And once you press this one, it will blink, the light will be flashing, and your tapping tool will retract or cancel the tapping cycle. If you didn't do that one, you are not able to make any command on your machine. That's why this button guys is very important too. And the next button is for the setup of your pallet. So you have pallet number 1 and pallet number 2, where on this pallet number 1 and pallet number 2, you can schedule a program number that you are going to run. If you're running 2 pallets on this machine, your machine is going to say, and your scheduled program number 200 on your pallet number 2. And then the next button guys is, this is your tool status. Tool status guys is different from tool data. This is your tool status, customized software matrix for the status for the matrix. So you have this tool holder. If you have tool holder on tool number 3, so you must have 0 after your tool. And if your the tool you have on tool number 3 is heavy or large, you can also put L for large. And then guys, this is the shortcut for your rain show. So if you press that button, the machine will go directly on your probing probing the screen on green show. And then guys, this is for your coolant. And this button is to switch off your coolant. So it's off. And the next button is your spindle through coolant. As you can see, that's very strong spindle coolant. And this one is supposed to be a flat coolant at the top of your machine, the overhead of the machine, but it doesn't work at the moment. And this is for your hair. You can see beside the spindle there is a small nozzle, that's for the airflow. And this is the another shower for your machine. And then this is your for the spiral of your conveyor, for the swarf, that's forward, and the other one is reverse, that's reverse. And this one guys is for the disc collector. So we have you installed the disc collector, and then this is your light. If you want to set your machine to automatic switch off, say you're going home and your machine is not yet done the operation and you want to switch it off, and you can also set the machine to automatic power on in the morning even if you're not still around at your work. So you can set your machine to automatic off and automatic switch on. This is guys your keyboard, where you can see all the letters and numbers. And we have our reset. And if you need some help, so you can press this help. And then on the position, where you can see all the position of your machine, you have the relative, the machine, the distance to go. You have your absolute, you have your relative, all, so you can see them all. Then you can see also your feed, and all your, you can see all your model, G-codes and M-codes, that is currently active on your machine. And then guys, if you press program, so you can see the actual program, and you have this rewind, all this background edit, insert, post search, actual position, you have preset, measure last button, so you have offset setting, where you can see all your stone offset, the wear length, geometry, the wear on radius. And then you have the setting, and then you have your work, the WCS or work coordinate system. Then you have the message, if you have the alarm, you have the alarm history, or you have the message history. And then you have your graph parameter, so this is your graph. And guys, your custom number one, where you can see your toll data, deload, APC, backup, reinitio guide, then G-code and M-code, NC program. This is the old fanuc screen. And then you have your, this one is the custom number two. Thank you again guys for watching this tutorial video. I hope you find this one helpful. If you like it, please give us a thumbs up. Also guys, please leave your comment down below that you subscribe, and I will try my best to reply to you as soon as I can. And if you have any suggestions that you want me to do, to vlog, please leave your comment down below. And again,
Thank you so much for all the time. And see you on my next video. See you guys.